I feel like when we have wilderness areas, it's nice to have at least a little bit of access so we can see, well, for people to see what it is that they're protecting when we have wilderness.
So now come sit down, will you talk with me now? Let me see through your eyes where there is so much light. We're biding our time.
We're at Blake's Bar on the Chetco River in Kalniopsis Wilderness, and it is the most beautiful place.
It was a dam on dry land of logs and bushes everywhere for like, I don't know, a half a mile, quarter of a mile. It was a long ways of just barely getting through to where you could be far enough apart from each other where you weren't hitting each other with logs.
We come out here and sweat our butts off to redo trails.
Well, we do a lot of treading, digging out of the hillside and creating a nice bench for people to walk on. Do a lot of lopping, clearing out some brush in the area, cross-cutting logs. Do a lot out here.
We have to hike in with our packs, and I haven't been sleeping in a tent at all. My pad is like this big. Like, I don't know, it's not ideal for most people, and I feel like it's been the best summer that I've ever had.
I'm definitely coming back out into the Kalliopsis. This is my favorite wilderness.
Why?
Because it's the roughest, it's the most difficult.
Kalliopsis was kind of barren looking. It's unlike any forest I've seen before. That was really my first experience with the mountains. So it was pretty cool, but there wasn't much cover. Pretty sunny, pretty hot. A lot of dead logs to move out of the way, throw off the trail, a lot of brushy spots. But it was a lot of fun. It was where I think we all kind of figured out what we were doing, what we were in for the summer. So it was kind of fun for us all to figure that out together.
I found out about SMC through a friend saying, oh, I think you would like this. And so I started volunteering, and then I saw like what a great crew was out here doing the work, and I was like, dude, I really want to be a part of this. And I didn't like know if I fully wanted to make the commitment, and then it kind of just became apparent that it was something that I needed to do for myself.
In some places in the Kalliopsis, you're just finding the path based on cairns and stacks of rocks. I knew it would be really difficult. I've been in the Kalliopsis before, and so I knew the terrain, and I was expecting it to be super hard and sweating a lot and lots of sun exposure, and that's what I got.
The only expectations I think I had coming out here was that I didn't know what to expect because I had never been backpacking before. I've never done trail work before. It was all very new to me.
Yesterday's hike was not the easiest. The hike is 9 miles to get to Carter Creek, and it's really rough on the joints and the feet because of all the rocks and blisters you gotta walk on. Wait, rocks and gravel you gotta walk on. I don't recommend my grandma walk it.
I like coming out into the wilderness and knowing that it's gonna be extremely difficult, but that at the end of it, you feel so great. Like hiking over a mountain or something. It's a great feeling when you're done.
My bed was all cozy and I had my tarp draped over me and it was clipped together with carabiners. And then around 1 a.m, I woke up to a few drops and it started just pouring down.
I
and the rain was just coming through my tarp and it was horrible. And I was like, this is not working out. I saw these logs that were kind of diagonal, and I figured I could make like a lean-to right there. I just kind of nestled myself under, and I just like curled up in a ball, and then the wind would blow and then it would screw everything up, and I'd have to re-put it up, and then it would happen again. And every single part of me was just soaking wet. And I woke up with these white pruny hands, and my feet were like that too, and it was horrible.
So surrounding us right now is a bunch of smoke. There's multiple fires going on, and one very close to the Calmeopsis, and we're definitely getting the smoke in today. The wind's blowing it right in towards us.
You have to pack in all your stuff. It's heavy. Get used to sleeping outside on the ground, which took a little while for me, at least. But then I started getting more comfortable, and Calmeopsis got me ready for the rest of the summer.
Your first trip.
My first experience out here, I wanted to die. My backpack was really heavy, and we hiked a lot uphill. I think a big part of it has to be the crew, because without the crew, then it's just hard work. With the crew, it's hard work that like everybody's in it together, and we just all grow so much throughout the summer, and you can like watch it happen. And
after this, I want to come back to do the Rogue Wilderness loop that we made. Hopefully, find my camera.
So when we open up trails that haven't been open for a very long time, for many years, feel very accomplished. I feel like we're really doing something good. We're providing a service to other hikers and backpackers who can enjoy it, and we're also getting a lot of experience ourselves, not only just learning the different techniques for clearing trails, but we're bonding as well. So it's definitely it's a community feel. It's just beneficial all around.
So like, people are gonna be coming in here no matter what, and people are going to be making campsites and like going off on little side trails that were originally animal trails, and it's just important for us to have like good trails that people want to hike on.
When I think of wilderness, I think of quietness, I think of peacefulness, I think of something that's undisturbed and untampered. It's a place where you can just go out and feel like you have more freedom, because you don't have to go to the regular 9-to-5 job or school or driving or anything like that. You can just go out and just be. Definitely feel like connects you to the earth more, and you can connect to your roots. I was surprised coming out here how comfortable I was out here. I thought I might feel exposed, or it might feel weird, but it's a very natural feeling to be out in nature.